Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so today continue with chapter 2 about system of linear equation. Okay, so objective. Okay, so you will understand the linear equation. Recognize a system of linear equation. So understand three possible solution of linear system linear equation. So actually here there is system. Okay, so system. Okay, system of linear equation. Okay, solution of system of linear equation. And last, solve a system of linear equation. So ni nanti cara dia kita akan ada Gaussian elimination method. Lepas tu Gauss-Jordan. Elimination method, and last one is inverse method. Okay, so first before that, okay, so we learn first what is linear equation. Okay, so linear equation is an algebraic equation in which each term, okay, so each term has a total power of 1, and the graphing of the equation result in a straight line. Okay, okay, so linear equation ni, so dia punya graph dia bentuk straight line lah. So ni kalau kita lukis graph lah. Okay, so kalau kita nak kenal daripada dia punya persamaan, ni. So total power of each term is 1. Okay, so for example, okay, so for the first one, linear equation with two variable. So kita ada dua pemboleh ubah, x dan y. So 2x plus y equal to 3. Okay, so term pertama, term kedua dan term ketiga. Okay, so the power of the variable total is 1. Here also total is 1. Okay, so number of variable next second is 3. Okay, so we have here x. Okay, so x plus 4y minus z equal to 2. So we have three variable, x, y and z. So pi ni bukan variable eh, pi number. Okay, so pi is a number. Okay, so kita tengok power of x. Here total power of x is 1. Y also total power is 1. And z also total power is 1. So next third, so linear equation with 4 variable. Okay. Okay, so we have a1 x1 plus a2 x2 a3 plus x3 plus a4 x4 equal to 3. Okay, so ni saya pakai variable dia x1, x2, x3, x4. So biasanya 2 variable xy, 3 variable xy, z. So 4 variable ni dah tak boleh lah nak pakai. Biasanya tak ada huruf lain, biasanya x, y, z lah. So bila sampai 4 variable ni, dia pakai x1, x2, x3, x4. Okay, so a1, a2, a3, a4 is constant. Next, nth variable. So a1, x1, a2, x2, a3, x3 and so on until anx n equal to. Okay, so example of non-linear equation. Okay, so for the first one, xz plus y equal to 3. So this one not linear equation because for the first term, x and z, x power is 1, z power is 1. So this one total power equal to 2. Okay, so total power equal to 2. Okay, so yang ni bukan linear equation. Second, cos x cos y. So this one trigo. Okay, so sebab trigo. So trigo is not linear equation. Okay, so kalau dulu ambil calculus, ni graf dia bentuk macam ni kan. Ha. So dia bukan straight line. Ha. Ha, ni trigo. So that's why it is not linear equation. Next, number 3, 1 over x minus 1 over y equal to 5. Okay. So this one, 1 over x, 1 over y. So if you learn in next, 1 over x is equal to x power of negative 1. 1 over y is equal to y power of negative 1 equal to 5. Okay, so power dia berapa ni? Negative 1. Okay. So power not 1. So power dia bukan 1. Okay, so that's why it is not linear equation. Okay, so ni contoh linear equation. Okay, so system of linear equation. So what is system of linear equation? So system of linear equation is group of more than one linear equation. Okay, kalau dulu korang belajar persamaan serentak kan, contoh macam 2x tambah y sama dengan 3 dan 4x tolak y sama dengan 5. Okay, so this one also we already call it as system of linear equation. Okay, so persamaan serentak ni pun dah dipanggil sebagai system of linear equation. Okay, ha, ni kat sini saya dah tulis example ni. So another example, this one. Okay, so x minus 2y and so on. Here is 3 variable. Okay, so 3 variable and 3 equation. For the first one, this one is 2 variable and 2 equation. This one? So this one, 1, 2, 3. So 3 variable. 3 variable. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 equation. Ini adalah system of linear equation. So ni general form dia lah. So n variable and m equation. Tak payah hafal general form ni pun tak apa. Janji korang tahu apa maksud system of linear equation. Okay, so next type of solution. So type of solution. Okay, so in term of graph, so if the two line does not intersect, so just parallel like this. Okay, so there is no solution. Okay, and this system we call it as inconsistent. Okay, so next, if there is one intersection, so we have one solution. And if the line, the both line bertindih macam ni, dalam satu garisan ada dua line ni, so meaning that it has infinitely many solution. Okay, so this two, if the system have one solution and infinitely many solution, so we call it the system is consistent. Okay, so kita panggil system tu consistent lah, sebab dia ada solution. Kalau tak ada solution, dia tak consistent. Okay, inconsistent. Okay, so ni gambaran dalam 2D je lah. So kalau dalam 3D tu, line dia akan bersilang-silang lah. Kalau tak bersilang, dia tak ada solution. So ni dalam bentuk graf. So nanti kita tengok dalam bentuk calculation macam mana. Okay. So next, so before you solve the matrix, not matrix, solve the system of linear equation, so you need to transform system of linear equation into matrix equation and then form augmented matrix. So dah sampai augmented matrix ni, baru kita selesaikan menggunakan Gauss elimination, Gauss-Jordan elimination or inverse method. Okay. Okay, so contoh, kita tengok contoh je lah ya. Okay, so this one we have system of linear equation. Okay. So first, transform it into matrix equation. So macam mana nak ambil? Okay, so dia memang akan ada bentuk T ni. So A, X, B. Okay. So B yang ujung ni, yang ni lah. So ni akan jadi sebagai B. Okay, so 7, 4 and negative 10. X So x is variable. So we have variable x, y, and z. So put here x, y, and so next we have here a. So a ni coefficient of each variable. Okay, so for the first one we have 1, negative 2, 3. 1, negative 2, and 3. And then second we have 2, 1, 1. And third we have negative 3, 2, negative 2. Okay, so negative 3, 2, and negative 2. Okay, so kenapa kita susun macam ni? So sebelum ni korang belajar matrix multiplication kan? So kalau kita darab ni macam mana? Matrix A times by matrix X. Okay, so we have row times by column. Okay, so kalau korang darabkan balik ni semula, so 1 times by X, X plus by negative 2 times by Y, negative 2Y, 3 times by Z, so positive 3, Z is equal to 7. Okay, so korang akan dapat persamaan yang pertama ni. Okay, so korang akan dapat persamaan yang pertama. Okay, so dah dapat matrix equation, and then we form the augmented matrix. Okay, so macam mana kita nak buat augmented matrix ni? So augmented matrix, you just take matrix A and matrix B. Okay, so 1, negative 2, 3, 2, 1, 1, 3, 2, negative 1, and then put a big slash. So here 7, 4, and negative 10, and then close bracket. Okay, so next example. Okay, number 2. So we have A X equal to B. So matrix A, coefficient of each variable, which is 1, 2, negative 4. So 1, 2, negative 4, and then negative 1, negative 1, 6, and then 12. So 2, tapi Y tak ada ni kan? So dekat Y kita letak, we put 0, and Z is 12, and here he is X, Y, Z, is equal to B. So 5, negative 6, and 9. Okay, okay, so kalau siapa yang tak faham tu macam mana nak susun nombor-nombor ni, korang letak kat sini. So first column, coefficient for X. Second column, coefficient of Y. Third column, coefficient of Z. Okay, nanti kita tengok contoh yang ketiga ni. Okay, so next, the augmented matrix. So take matrix A and matrix B. So we have here 1, 2, negative 4, negative 1, negative 1, and 6. And then 2, 0, 12. And slash 5, negative 6, and 9. Okay, so next, last, number 3. So matrix A times by X equal to B. Okay, so siapa yang tak boleh tadi, tak coefficient X, Y, dan Z. But now we use X1, X2 kan? So X1 and X2 je lah, because there is no X3. So for X, here is X1 and X2. Is equal to B. So B is 9, 12, and negative 6. Okay, so coefficient of X1, so 3. And then coefficient of X2, negative 6. Then coefficient of X1 for the second equation, 4. Then negative 8. And last one is negative 2 and positive 4. So kat sini kita ada dua row, tapi kat sini kita ada 3. Tak ada masalah ke? Tak ada. So berpatah balik pada konsep yang tadi tu, multiplication of two matrix. So 3 times x1, okay. So negative 6 times x2. So negative 6 x2 is equal to 9. So dapatlah persamaan yang pertama. Okay, so tak ada masalah. Okay, so now the augmented matrix for this system is 3, negative 6, 4, negative 8, negative 2 and 4, slash 9, 12 and negative 6. Okay, so next. Ini tadi saya cerita, so method for solving system of linear equation. So we have 3 method: Gaussian elimination method, Gauss-Jordan elimination method and inverse method. So Gaussian elimination method ni macam mana kita nak buat? So use ERO to convert out augmented matrix into REF. So apa tu REF? Apa tu REO? ERO. So nanti kita tengok. So semuanya berkaitan dengan augmented matrix. Gauss-Jordan pun kita ada augmented matrix. So after that, use back substitution to obtain all the answer. Gauss-Jordan pun sama, use back substitution to obtain all the answer. Cuma beza dia kat sini je lah. So REF and RREF. Okay. So nanti kita tengok what is REF and RRE. Okay, so before that, okay, so what is ERO? Elementary row operation. Okay. So elementary row operation ni, so kita akan buat operasi tambah tolak darab macam tu lah. Okay. So first interchange I's row with J row. So kat sini kita ada row ni, saya tertinggal. So I's row with J row. So row I we interchange with row J. Second, we can do multiply I row with a non-zero constant C. Okay. So constant C times by row I and then put back at row I. If row 1, so C times row 1 and then put back at row. So this one put back. This one interchange. Okay. Third, multiply I row with a non-zero constant C and adding it to J row. Okay. So C row I plus row J and then put at row J. Okay. So put back at row J. Okay, so kita tengok contoh example. Okay, so example first one, this one interchange first row with second row. So yang ni berkaitan yang pertama tadi ni lah, interchange I row with J row. So kita tubah. Okay, interchange. Okay. So row first become row second. Okay, nampak? And then row second become row third. Okay. Next, multiply the first row with 1/3. Ini tadi constant. So 1/3 row 1, 1/3 times by row 1 and then put back at row 1. Okay, so dia berkaitan dengan yang second ni. Okay. So 1/3 times 3 is 1, 1/3 times 12 is 4 and then 1/3 times negative 6 is negative 2 and the rest same. Yang lain dia sama. Okay, so this one and this one same. Tak berubah. So yang berubah row 1 sahaja. Okay, so next. Ini berkaitan yang nombor 3 tadi. Okay, so multiplying the first row with negative 2 and adding it to the third row. Okay, so kita tengok row first times by negative 2 plus row 3 and put back at row 3. Okay. So nampak dia letak dekat row yang ketiga. So pertama dengan kedua dia tak berubah, 2, 1, 3, 0, sebab dia letak balik dekat row ketiga, okay. So formula dia tadi apa? First row times by negative 2 and then plus by row 3, okay. So yang negative 4 yang pertama ni, so negative 2 times by row 1 which is 2 and then plus by row 3, so row 3 is 0, plus by 0 which is equal to negative 4. And here negative 4, negative 2 times by row 1 which is 1 plus by row 3, so row 3 is negative 2, plus by negative 2. So you have here negative 2 minus 2 which is negative 4, okay. Next, so kita masuk, ni tadi REF. So what is rho echelon form? Okay. Okay, so rho echelon form is said, a matrix is said to be in rho echelon form if it is satisfied the following condition. Okay, so first, any zero row is placed at the bottom of the matrix. Okay, so zero row, ini zero row. So baris yang ada kosong semua ni kita panggil sebagai zero row. Okay, so placed at the bottom, kat bawah ni. Okay, so yang ni kotak hijau ni, example for row echelon form lah. Okay, so zero row dekat bottom. Okay, so B, for each non-zero row, so each non-zero row, ni non-zero row lah. Okay, so this one non-zero row, this one also non-zero row, this one also non-zero row. The first non-zero entry is 1. Okay, so this, we call it as leading 1. Okay, so for the first row, this one is non-zero row, the first leading is 1. And then second, leading is 1. Third leading is 1, okay. Yang kosong ni kita tak kira lah, kita kira yang satu je, okay. Next, for two consecutive non-zero rows, the leading 1 in the below row is further to the right than the leading 1 in the row above, okay. So contoh, okay, contoh yang ni lah, ni tadi dah tengok kan, okay. So contoh yang ni, row first and row second, okay. So kita tengok leading for the first row is 1 here, dan dekat sini. Okay, so leading untuk second row, dia akan lagi ke kanan, okay. So dia akan lagi ke kanan, okay. So dekat sini ni, okay. Contoh yang lain lagi sekali, okay. So lagi sekali kita tengok, okay, so for two consecutive non-zero row, ataupun kita tengok lah yang ni 3 row, 1, 2, 3, okay. So for the first row, leading 1 is here. Second row, leading 1 dia akan pergi ke kanan, okay, so here. Third row, leading 1 dia akan lagi pergi ke kanan, okay. Contoh yang bawah ni, okay, so contoh yang ni. Okay, so first row, leading 1 dia dekat sini. Second row, leading 1 dia, dia lagi kanan. Ni jauh kan? Ni tak ada masalah. Yang penting dia lagi kanan. Okay, okay, so kita tengok non-zero. Non-row echelon form yang bukan ni. Kenapa dia bukan? Okay, so first, for the first row, leading is not 1. Okay, so leading dia bukan 1. So dia bukan row echelon form. Okay, this one, yang ni pula. Okay, so for the first row, leading dia dekat sini. But second row, leading dia kat kiri. Okay, so leading 1 is not at the right of leading 1 for first row. Okay. So dia tidak berada di kanan daripada leading satu yang ni. Okay. So dekat kiri. So dia bukan row echelon form. Okay, so this one third. Yang ni pula. Okay. So this is leading one here. Leading sec for the second one. Leading one for the second row. Okay, so cantik dia pergi ke kanan. But here leading one for the third row. Ha? So dia dekat bawah ni. Dia sama. Ha? Dia sama. Dia tak ke kanan. So dia tak ke kanan. So therefore it is not row echelon form. Okay. Okay, so how to use ERO to obtain row echelon form. Okay. So ERO tadi kita ada tiga operasi: interchange, multiply by a constant, and then multiply by a constant and adding to another row. Okay. And then row echelon form, leading dia satu dan makin bawah makin ke kanan, dan zero row dia sentiasa dekat bottom. Okay, so yang ni, how to use ERO to obtain REF. Okay, so kita tengok this one already REF or not. Okay, so not yet. Okay, so to form REF, okay, so first row kita tengok row yang pertama ni. Okay, so kita tengok leading row yang pertama. Okay, so step dia tengok leading dia. So leading dia satu kan? Satu kan? Betul. Okay, so betul. Okay, so leading dia satu. Okay, cantik. Okay, so lepas tu bawah dia ni kena kosong. Kalau kita tengok tadi yang atas. Okay, so kita tengok yang atas ni. So kalau leading dia satu, bawah dia sentiasa kosong. Sini satu, bawah dia kosong. Yang ni pun sama. Leading dia satu, bawah dia kosong. Sini leading satu, bawah dia kosong. Okay. This one also same. Leading one and then the number bottom below of the leading one is zero. Okay. So therefore next objective dia kita nak buat yang ni kosong. Okay, so how to make buat kosong? So kita guna ERO operasi tadi. So interchange, multiply or multiply I row with a non-zero constancy and adding it to J row. Okay. Okay, so so macam nak jadikan kosong, darab kosong. Darab kosong boleh, tapi tak advice lah darab kosong tu. Situ constant number lah. Okay, so macam nak jadikan kosong, okay, so kita ada, kita kaitkan first row and second row. Okay, so we have here row 2 and row 1. And then we need to be 0. Okay. So row 2, so row 2 we have 4. Okay. Row 1 is 1 equal to 0. Okay, so what we need to do here? Okay, so kita boleh darabkan dengan constant dekat row 1. Yang row 2 ni tak payahlah sebab sini 4 kan. So 4 minus by 4 times 1. Betul tak? So 4 tolak 4 darab 1 dapat 0. Okay, so therefore we need to do the equation here is row 2 minus by row 1. Okay, so untuk jadikan dia 0. Okay, so next kita dah dapat formula ni, kita buatlah. So row 2 minus by 4 row 1 and then we put back at row 2 sebab row 1 tadi kita dah ada dah betul lah. So 1 1 1, so tak payah usik row 1. Okay. So kita letak dekat row 2. Okay, so yang pertama first one row 2 is 4, so 4 minus by times 1 which is 0. Then second negative 3, so negative 3 kira sikit, negative 3 minus by 4 times 1 which is equal to negative 7. Negative 7. Next, 11. So 11 minus by 4 times by 1. So the answer is berapa? 11 tolak 4, 7. Okay. Okay. So next, for the second row, leading dia satu ke tak? Bukan. Okay. So macam nak jadikan satu? So negative 1, negative 7. Okay. So negative 7 times by what? Equal to 1. Okay. So negative 7 times by negative 1 over 7. Okay, so therefore the operation is negative 1 over 7 times by row 2 and put back at row 2. Okay, so you have here 1 1 1 0, negative 1 over 7 times by negative 7, so we have 1, and then negative 1 over 7 times by 7 is negative 1. So this is the answer. Okay. Okay, so another example. Okay, so tengok leading dia. Okay, so first tengok leading dia. Okay, so the leading is not 1 for the first row. Okay, so focus for the first row and leading. Okay, so first focus on the leading of row 1. Okay, so tengok leading dia. So sekarang ni 2 bukan 1. So macam mana nak jadikan 1? So nak jadikan 1 darab dengan times by 1 over 2. Okay. Okay, so times by 1 over 2. Okay, so row 1 times by 1 over 2 and put back at row 1. So you have here 1 over 2 times 2, 1. And then 1 over 2 times 2 is also 1. And then 1 over 2 times by 2 also 1. Okay. So second row. Second row is we didn't touch it. So we have 2, 3 and 7. Here 1, 3 and negative 2. Okay. So next. So here already 1. Okay, so usually use. Okay, so biasanya kita akan gunakan use leading 1 at row 1 to obtain element below leading 1 to be 0. Okay, so biasa kita akan gunakan leading 1 ni untuk jadikan bawah dia ni kosong. Okay, so we have here row 2 and row 3. Okay, so objektif dia nak jadikan ni kosong dua ni. Okay, so to be 0. Okay, so macam mana? Okay, so on the third row, kalau kita nampak kat sini, third row 1 minus by 1. Okay. So kita boleh buat serentak ni. For the second row 2, here is 1. 2 minus 2 is 0, right? Okay. So 2 times 2 minus by 2 times 1. Okay, so you have here row 2. For the row 2, so row 2 minus by 2 times by row 1 and put back at row 2. And the third row, row 3 minus row 3, and then row 3 minus row 1. Okay, so row 3 minus row 1 and put back at row 3. Okay, so you have here 1 1 1. Okay, so row 1 tadi dah jadi kan, so jangan usik. So second row, row 2 minus 2 row 1. Okay, so 2 minus by 2 times 1, so 0. 3 minus by 2 times 1, so 3 minus 2 which is 1, and 7 minus 2 times by 1 which is 5. Okay. So ingat row 1 tadi. Okay. So next third row. Okay. Row 3 minus row 1. So 1 minus by 1 0, and then 3 minus by 1 is 2, and then negative 2 minus by 1 is negative 3. Okay. So leading 1 for the first row already 1. Okay, so leading 1 for the second row already got it. And then next, so bawah leading 1 must be 0. Okay. So next, fokus kita, objektif kita, kita nak jadikan 2 ni kosong. Okay. So how to obtain here 0? So 2 minus by 2 times 1. So therefore row 3 minus by 2 times by row 2, and then put back at row 3. Okay, so you have 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 5, and then yang ni tak ada masalah biasanya ni. Okay, so row 3 is row 3, 0 minus by 2 times by row 2 is 0. So 0 minus by 0, 0 lah. Okay, so next 2. 2, row 3 is 2, and then 2 times row 2 is 1. So 2 minus by 2 times by 1 which is 0. Then next negative 3. So negative 3 put here, negative 3 minus by 2 times 5. So negative 3 minus by 2 times by 5 is 10. So negative 13. Okay. So next, so this one leading 1, leading 1. Okay, so leading 1 for the third row. So macam mana nak buat? So this one we change to become 1. Okay. So this one is macam nak jadikan 1? Negative 1 over 13. Negative 13 times by negative 1 over 13. Betul? So meaning that negative 1 over 13 times by row 3, and put back at row 3. Okay, so therefore you have the answer here 1, 1, 1. Second row. So 0, 1, 5. And third row is 0 times negative 1 over 13, 0. And then 0 times negative 1 over 13, 0. And negative 13 times negative 1 over 13 is 1. Okay, so dah siap row echelon form. Okay. Okay. Okay, so I think that's all for today. So sampai sini saja untuk row echelon form. Okay, so next I will teach you about the Gaussian elimination method. Okay. So try ingat balik macam mana nak buat ERO untuk reduce kepada row echelon form. Okay. So nanti kita akan apply dalam Gaussian elimination method. Okay. Okay, so that's all. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.